Hello, Seattle.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello, world.
Hello, Cleveland. Hello, Cleveland.
Well, hello.
Wholly independent and completely untethered since 2009, this is the Marty Reamer Show podcast.
Reamer. Reamer. Reamer.
From the epicenter, Seattle, USA.
West side.
From their west side basement, lodged between the mold and the bad memories.
Quiet, numbskulls, I'm broadcasting.
Here are your hosts, Marty Reamer and somebody else.
All right, podcast. Welcome to a gorgeous Thursday. Sure happy it's Thursday.
Sure happy it's Thursday, Marty.
Favorite day of the week. Don't speak until we've introduced you, because otherwise people don't know who that voice belongs to. It is our favorite day of the week. Chain of restaurants we're planning on opening at the Marquee. Sure happy it's Thursday. Probably too long. We'll have to shorten it up. Get it? Our co-host today is the old show producer who comes here whenever he's given a little window of opportunity from his day job. Brian Muchinski is here. Brian Muchinski, there he is.
Thank you, Marty. Sorry I broke rule number one. I was just channeling Jody for a second there.
Nice to have you here, Brian.
Thank you very much for having me. I have nothing to plug this time. Last time I was plugging that improv show pretty hard, but now I'm just here to hang out.
Well, then I'll take your place. I have something to plug. It's a gorgeous day. I think it's a gorgeous day for a little boat outing. We're planning on taking a little ride on an Argosy ship later this evening with none other than Augustana is how I pronounce it. But now watch. Listen to this. Listen to this introduction, which is in direct conflict with my pronunciation.
All right, my next guest is a terrific band from San Diego. They're kicking off a tour in Dallas, Texas at the House of Blues on May 12th. Tonight they're performing Steal Your Heart from their self-titled album, Augustana. Please welcome Augustana.
August. Put in my place. Dan Leas from Augustana is here in the moldy basement this morning. Hello, Dan.
Good morning.
I was told just the other day that all this time... And I'm a huge fan, so if I get it wrong, I have been mispronouncing the name of the band that I bow down to.
Anything you want to call it, man, as long as you can spell it, which is still a challenge in itself.
I can get that. I got the spelling.
Ironically, Jay Leno cannot.
So you say Augustana, though.
I guess lately I have.
All right.
Changes year to year.
It's so funny because now, since I was told that I was pronouncing it wrong, now I've switched over to Augustana, and I feel like such a sellout. Like I should have stayed true to my convictions for just a little bit longer, but I couldn't do it. Nice to have you here, Dan. Thanks very much for coming by.
Thank you for having me.
I am, as I've mentioned, once, twice, maybe a few dozen times, I'm a big fan. I'm a big fan of theirs, especially the live performances. And I said this yesterday, and people will think I do not have the cojones to say it to your face, but I will say it to your face, Dan. There's something about you in a live performance that if I had not met you outside of a show, I would think there was something wrong with you.
You might not be wrong, man.
The first time I saw you, I thought, oh my God, that guy is brilliant on stage. He totally loses himself in his performance. And then I saw you guys afterwards in the green room, and everyone was sitting around reading a book. And I was going, so normal, so freakish, so normal, so
reading
freakish.
Foreign Affairs and The Economist.
Exactly.
Talking about the stock market.
On the phone with Hillary Clinton.
Exactly.
So I don't know what kind of a zone you go into when you're on stage. Is that what it feels like to you?
Yeah, I mean, it's a departure, I think, from normal life for us and certainly for me. I think it's just one of those... I just feel really natural there. I think being a dad and being on stage are the two things where I feel the most comfortable and in my skin, I guess.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, you certainly are good with kids, too. We all have something in common, all three of us. We all have kids very close to the same age.
Yes.
Myself, Brian, and Dan.
Yeah.
Dan and I, almost exactly the same age.
Mm-hmm.
Not us.
No, you're much, much older.
Oh, Lordy knows. I was born in a whole different era. But a 4.5-year-old girl, mm-hmm. and roughly a 1-year-old boy.
Yes, sir.
So and so my kids came down here because one of my daughter's favorite songs is Sweet and Low. And so
that's
I had
great.
To point out the man that gave her that song. Because that song is now, because it came out right around the time she was born, because that's mm-hmm. about 4-ish years old
yeah.
now, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So does it kill you a little bit to be away from the kids when you're out on the road?
Yeah, it's tough, man. I mean, but dad, you know, dad's got to work sometimes.
Dad's got
to work sometimes, at least, you know. And it's, you know,
don't let my kids hear that, because I'm trying to convince them that dad may not work all the time.
Yeah, you know, it's good, and you know, and it's a great job, man. I can't complain.
Yeah,
you know.
Speaking of your Tonight Show appearance, mm-hmm. So I watched that. That was just a couple weeks ago.
Yes.
And was everyone on stage in the band? Because suddenly it looked like you had 18 members in Augustana.
Yeah, exactly. No, we just keep piling them on for these for these TV performances. It's one of those things where it's really hard to match sonically what you can do on a record. And, you know, we always tried to, you know, be really, really strict about who's on stage and make sure it's just the band and the players and stuff like that. But it was like, you know what? These opportunities are so few and far between. You don't know how long you're going to have the chance. You might as well just throw on as many people as you can.
I was wondering if that was the case. Like, if I could have just called you up saying, I'd love to be on the Tonight Show. Can I just stand back in the back and not
anytime.
Do anything?
Anytime. Really? Anytime. Anybody's welcome.
I'll be the 17th member.
You can hold a maraca and play that in the background.
Yeah, just as long as I don't actually shake it. That's when sure. trouble begins.
Just look pretty.
So officially, how many members? Is it five?
We got a core group of about four or five guys. And then, you know, depending on where we are, we've developed a lot of friendships and acquaintances over the years and tours. You know, depending on if we're on the East Coast or West Coast or Los Angeles, you know, Nashville, you know, we have players.
Really? It's that fluid. You can bring people in.
Yeah,
the
yeah.
Fold and...
We've just done so many tours and played with so many bands that and created so many sort of relationships that... Yeah, you know, if we're in Tennessee, we know a guy, a dobro player, who will come up and, you know, play a set with us. Or on the West Coast, you know, we have a pedal steel player that jumps up on stage and plays a show. And it's just nice because it brings a new element that, you know, maybe most of the time we don't have.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah.
Although that flies completely counter to what I'd always heard, avoid the dobro players in Tennessee.
Avoid the dobro players.
At all costs.
Exactly.
All right, Augustana is here. They are performing tonight, full band, full complement of players. Is that correct?
Yes.
Tonight on the boat. And it's pretty full, but I suspect you might even be able to walk up and squeeze on the ship. It leaves at 7 o'clock, Pier 55. And ignore all my previous statements about avoid parties on boats. Ignore anything I may have said about that.
This is the exception that proves the rule.
That's right. Generally, that's the case. Except, I have to tell you this. A, phenomenal live band. B, all the most memorable performances I've ever experienced in my life have been in unusual venues like a boat or, right. you know, on a trip to Mexico with an artist and that kind of thing.
Right.
Nowadays, when you see a band in a theater, maybe this is just me because the industry I'm in, but when you see a band in a theater, they kind of blend together. But right. when you see them in a unique situation, yeah. anyway, that'll
exactly.
stand out. So, Dan, you what are you going to play for us here?
I'll start off with a song off our new record called Shot in the Dark.
All right. Yeah. The new record is out next Tuesday. It's their fourth album and self-titled, which screws us in the radio industry up. Because when you see self-titled, you think, debut release from Augustana.
Right. Exactly.
But it's their fourth album, and here to play something off of it is their frontman, Dan Leas.
All right. Thank you. I had a vision for the life that was ahead of me. I had a reason, had a right, and had a destiny. I thought I knew where I was headed, I would never look back. I had it all, and then I went and let it slip away. I'm working overtime, I'm gonna make it anyway. Sometimes you win, sometimes you lose, sometimes you never get her back. Oh, you know, but I'm rising up slowly and getting higher. I've been living with a hole in my heart weighing down on me, but I'm a fighter and I know I still got
got a shot in the dark. Baby, we still got a shot in the dark. Sometimes in life you meet the people that you think you trust. Wake up one day and find that everything had turned to dust. I always knew be waiting for me when I got back. Waiting when I came, rising up slowly and getting higher. Well, I've been living with a hole in my heart weighing down on me, but I'm a fighter and I know I still got a shot in the dark. Baby, we still got a shot in the dark. But I'm gonna find a way. I'm gonna find a way out. I'm gonna find a way. Cause I got a vision for the life that's right in front of me. I got a right, I got a reason, got a destiny. I know exactly where I'm headed and I'm never looking back. Cause nothing's holding me back. Man, nothing's holding me back. From rising up slowly and getting higher. I've been living with a hole in my heart weighing down on me, man. Well, I'm a fighter and I know I still got a shot in the dark. Rising up slowly, I'm getting higher. Well, I've been living with a hole in my heart weighing down on me, baby. I'm a fighter and I know I still got a shot in the dark. Baby, we still got a shot in the dark. But I know I still got a shot.
Wow, beautiful. Beautiful, people. That is Augustana, Shot in the Dark, a track off the new CD, which will be out next. I say track, it's a song off the new CD that was performed live here on the podcast, off the CD that looks just like this, and it will be out next Tuesday. So I just got my hands on the first one of the early releases here. You guys look angry on the cover of the CD.
Very angry, just very angry.
Very angry man. You know why it is? It's a San Diego band, and it looks like you're in
chilly New York,
in a very cold part of the country. Yeah.
Yes,
I'd be mad too.
Exactly.
Who scheduled this? The reason that it's a self-titled CD? Did you just say too much with titles and all?
Well, you know, it's been 3 years since our last release. We put a lot of time, a lot of energy, a lot of focus. A lot of, I know it's kind of cliche, no blood, but definitely sweat and tears. Uh-huh.
So it was an arduous process getting this album out.
Certainly. Lots of ins and outs and what have yous in getting to this point. Needless to say, we are extremely satisfied to be having this album come out on Tuesday. But the self-titled thing came about very early. I just kind of knew probably the day after our last release, I was like, this next record's got to be really special. It's got to be the stamp. You know?
Mm-hmm. So that's what that means. When you self-title an album, it's like, this represents us.
I don't know about other bands. I would assume it's probably similar. Mm-hmm. But it definitely, for me, it was definitely some sort of statement. I don't know, self-indulgent statement. I don't know.
And why was it such an arduous process? Was it was someone else inflicting the pain on you guys, or was it
no? You know, it's just like anything. Any kind of creative process or any other kind of job that people have. You know, and it's funny because it just lined up right in time with the U.S. economy melting down, mm-hmm. and the the housing crisis and the unemployment rate. It just seemed everything was just lining up right in time, and it just felt like I was riding the storm with the rest of the world. You know, yeah. Whether you were working on the docks and lost your job, or you're trying to make a living, making music, which is maybe in some ways just as difficult.
Yeah.
That's
interesting, because it is always that most people rely on their personal pain to come up with great art. So I mean, right. If there's a lot of pain going on in the world, I would imagine that also generates some great music.
Yeah, certainly. I think a combination of just absorbing a lot of things around me, but also drawing a lot from my own personal life as well.
That's cool. The CD again out next Tuesday, and we've got them in town to play Marty Party Number 4 this evening aboard an Argosy boat. We will get another song out of Dan here, but Brian joins us. We don't do this all that often these days unless we get a broadcast professional in.
You're very kind.
So we want to take a little break here to find out what's happening in the world. Yesterday, of course, was 4:20, so you probably have no idea what was going on in the world. You completely checked out.
And back when I was your old show producer, for a while I got to do a sports cast, and I miss it, so I'm doing a sports theme for you, because your listeners don't get a lot of sports.
Well, then before you dive into the sports, okay. One breaking bit of news here that you may have missed yesterday on 4:20. It's like the state was taunting us on the pot smokers' holiday. I don't know if you caught the wind of this, but the state of Washington yesterday announced a ban on bath salts.
Yeah.
Bath salts.
Yeah.
That's insane. And lest you think our state is down on pampering yourself, apparently...
Kids are getting high.
The kids again with their getting high. The ban makes it illegal to sell, buy, or use bath salts in our state. First off, I guess I need to take a couple steps back. What is the legitimate use of bath salts?
I guess they smoke it. I'm not.
No, that's
totally
the illegitimate.
Oh no! good. I'll handle this one. You melt away the cares of your workaday life.
Pour them in your bath, and it softens the water.
It's an aroma. I mean, it's designed. The aroma is designed to relax you, so it's not that surprising. It's a slow, small step to smoking it and getting super high.
So instead, what the kids are doing, it's become a designer drug that you can snort or smoke, and it gives you a similar high to cocaine. For that, we turn to Yaz. Yaz, what kind of a high does it give you? Yaz has no idea what we're talking about. Manufacturers are taking advantage of a known loophole. Bath salts are labeled not for public consumption, but nobody reads those labels. It's like, what?
How many public baths are there anymore? Of course it's for private consumption. It's a bath salt.
Good point. Until now, anybody, even kids, could buy bath salts over the counter. Yeah, because...
Kids have stress?
Because they're bath salts, for God's sakes. Let me see. They can be found in Seattle area smoke shops, head shops, even mini marts under names like Ivory Wave. Okay, that still sounds like a legitimate name.
Sure.
Red Dove.
Closer.
All right. And one product labeled Charlie Sheen bath salts.
Shut up, dude.
Dead serious.
Are you kidding?
There's a Charlie Sheen with an extra E at the end so that you don't get into trouble the man.
Licensing,
Sounds like they got greedy. They had a nice little niche market, then you put Charlie Sheen's name on it, and now you're on the radar.
And then immediately the man comes cracking down on you. Apparently, emergency room technicians were saying, went to the government, to the state government, said, you got to do something about this stuff. Yeah. We're seeing too many kids check in, overdosing. I'm like, where have we come in society where, at what point do we just start drinking conditioner? Going, I wonder what this has got to have some kind of an effect on us.
Yeah,
I tend to trust the government because, again, this is the state that has legalized pot. So if they're cracking down on bath salts, I'm assuming there's a legitimate health reason for it.
And I'm talking to two other parents here. We're all parents. Have we learned nothing from raising our kids? I would have never thought anything untoward about bath salts until they made it illegal, and now I think I should maybe try it.
I
should maybe check out the
stress
effect
reliever
that bath salts have on me.
Crazy.
Dan, you keep bouncing back and forth between the illicit and the illicit.
Yeah.
You're like, oh, it's relaxing.
It's relaxing.
But only when you put it in the bath.
Right.
I think the other time it gets you wired.
Yeah.
All right. So beware, kids. Flush the bath salts. down the
That's
toilet.
Right.
Down the bathroom.
Although that might actually smell pretty good because they'll dissolve in the toilet by the time they go down.
If you're flushing them down the toilet and then on your knees going, then you've got a problem. All right, what else is going on, Brian, in the world?
Well,
of sports?
All right, here's what you need to know about what's going on in the world of sports. The NBA playoffs, Marty, are underway, but you don't have to start caring for about 2 more months.
Okay.
They're going to be going on until late
I paid a little
June.
Attention because Oklahoma was in the playoffs, and that is actually a.k.a. Seattle Sonic.
When you see your ex-girlfriend in the mall, you check out what movie she's going to see. Yeah. I understand. But, but they'll be around for a little while. Don't sweat that. The Mariners lost 3-2 to the Tigers yesterday.
They won't be around much longer.
They have fallen to 6-13. Yes, Oklahoma City could probably help themselves to them. Not too many people would care. Felix Hernandez pitches tonight as the A's come in for a 4-game series. Pretty much all the seats are still available.
What about that one right behind home plate?
That one is also available.
Oh, really?
For the right price. Yeah. All right, so anyway, we're coming up, believe it or not, on the 10th anniversary of 9/11. Can you believe it? It's coming up this September. And the NFL has announced some games designed to really honor the occasion. You know, the NFL knows patriotism like nobody's business. So the Jets are going to be at home. The New York Jets will host the Dallas Cowboys, America's team. And so the Giants will have to play on the road for them both to play on 9/11. So they're going to be at, any guesses? Where would you send the Giants?
New Orleans.
Washington, D.C. Face the Redskins. So that is, of course, if they play football this year at all, which they're currently embroiled in a collective bargaining hoo-ha, so we'll have to see what happens there. And finally, this is fresh news just this morning from baseball. You probably, Marty, as being a relatively casual sports fan, which means you hate sports. So the Dodgers, do you know anything about the ownership of the Dodgers?
I do. I know that they're embroiled in a divorce.
Exactly. Right, so once upon a time, the Dodgers were like this happy spory in sports ownership. They were a mom and pop instead of being owned by some big corporation. Alas, mom and pop are splitting, and it has been just a descent into hell for this Frank McCourt, the owner of the Dodgers. It reached a new low this morning. Major League Baseball has announced they're actually going to take over the team.
Wow.
They're in such chaos that they can't make their payroll. They came to Major League Baseball and asked for a loan because these guys make this ton of money. You have to pay them every 2 weeks.
Yeah.
And so McCourt now, he's in litigation with his ex-wife, and he's threatened to sue baseball. Yeah. So keep your eye on that. And so say what you want about corporations, at least they never get divorced.
good point.
And that's sports.
Thank you very much, Brian.
You're welcome.
We're not used to having like a sports segment on the program. So
your listeners enjoy variety. They're very depth of topic interest.
Absolutely. Augustana is here. Dan Leas is representing Augustana. The first single off the CD is called Steal Your Heart, which we've been playing on the mountain. Beautiful song. Just watched the video this morning. I am back into videos. I'll tell you, videos are back.
They're back?
Now that I've realized that MTV is MTV and VH1 have abandoned videos, but it's cool because you can watch them on demand whenever you want to on YouTube.
Yeah.
So a cool video shot, I'm guessing, somewhere in the desert southwest.
Yeah.
Is that right?
Yeah, way out there in the desert.
Who did the location scout for the video?
I have no idea.
Someone just told you show up?
Yeah, but we found it.
Uh-huh.
We found it.
Remember
somehow.
The Indian in the Doors movie?
Exactly. It was the Indian.
It was that guy.
It was the Indian.
And so you show up there, and then it looks like a full day because you get different lighting. That's you know, starts with a beautiful sunset, and then by...
Yeah, it was a good 15 hours. It was pretty
15
crazy.
Hours. And then pyrotechnics.
Yeah, we went all the way with this one. I showed up, I had no idea there were going to be pyrotechnics, and I was like, wow, we're really going.
So they're really firing off the fireworks behind you. I kept watching it going, is this some kind of a video effect?
Yeah, it was real. It was real. And then they had weird kind of filters on the cameras that would then turn the lights into words and shapes, which was kind of interesting, you know.
So that wasn't done in post-production.
That was done at, they just put a little screen on the camera lens with, you know, the shape of a heart or whatever.
Yeah, yeah.
And it just naturally captured it as a heart. It's pretty crazy. Pretty basic, actually.
It must have been some tension involved because, you know, I mean, you have a finite number of rockets you can shoot into the air.
Yeah. The pyro guy, it was genius. He was just like that character, Danny McBride's character in Tropic Thunder. Yeah. He comes over after the first... You know what I'm talking about, right?
Yeah, of course.
Great
movie.
Just
wants to blow everything up.
Oh, yeah. He comes up after, and after the first take, you know, comes up to the director, and he's like, I can't cuss on the air, but he says something along the
lines
of...
Oh, we're not on the air, so you can go ahead and cuss. Yeah.
He says something along the lines of, like, what do you think of that shit? You know, like, you know, that kind of thing. Like, how about that, huh? Like, can you top that? You know, just like Danny McBride.
Because it starts out, you know, the first one is just kind of like, I'm thinking, oh, that's cool. They bring a little... you know, sparkler into the video. And yeah. then by the end, it's just like, boom, boom. Yeah. They're blowing off the side of a mountain.
Full on 4th of July.
Yeah. Anyhow, great song. And you got to check out the video. We'll put a link to it on our website, the Mountain's website, 1037themountain.com, and also MartyReamer.com. So is that what you're going to play next?
Yeah, I'll okay. go ahead and play that. Yeah.
So this is, I'm guessing this is going to be a completely different version than the one that's on the record.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, just play it in its most basic natural form, I suppose.
Well, meet me at the water. Let all your dreams come true. Tell your sisters and your brothers, we'll all be waiting for you. Yeah, when all of this is over and all your silver turns to gold, say a prayer for each other. Someday I'm gonna steal your heart. I'm gonna steal your heart. Gonna steal your heart away. Gonna steal your heart. Gonna steal your heart away. My love is like an ocean. I'll take you down to the depths. Well, I'm taking you with me, taking every step to steal your heart. Gonna steal your heart away. Gonna steal your heart. Gonna steal your heart away. Like a shadow, it never stays in one place. Hey, I'm standing here anyway. However long it takes to steal your heart, gonna steal your heart away. Gonna steal your heart. Gonna steal your heart.
That voice, is incredible. And this is early in the morning for a rock and roller, as we are reminded every single day by whoever comes in.
Yeah, no, dads, being a dad, man, it gets you up early. It's the best thing that ever happened to morning radio performances.
It's so true. Augustana, that's Dan Leyes from Augustana. The people in the chat room are going out of their minds. Although some of them are wondering how I'm managing to stay composed. What is this, Marty? You're staying pretty composed to have somebody you lost your shit over sitting right in front of you. So that is true. I got to play it cool, although I did kind of fawn a little bit right before the show started so that I could.
Yeah, I can attest to that. There was some fawning, yeah. Some fawnage.
Awkward for everyone in the room. And I apologize, Dan.
Show him the autograph on your shirt.
It's on my chest.
It's on his chest.
And some people are asking. You say everyone is coming out on the boat today, so
yeah, we got all five of us. All tonight. Five. Yeah.
Name them by name.
We got Justin, Jared. Oh, this is like a challenge.
Yeah, just quick. I want to see if you forget anybody here.
We got Chris and Andy and okay. myself, Daniel.
All right. I had a totally different list here.
Yeah.
I had John, Paul, George, and Ringo. But
yeah, exactly.
Totally confused.
Exactly.
Thank you so much for coming by. And,
thank you for having
and,
me.
And all the best to you. I hope this new CD is here. Take another look at it. Don't take a look at Brian. There we go.
I don't have it. They haven't given me one yet.
Me either.
I know, literally. That's weird. When literally. You got here, you said you yeah. just got a copy of the CD. So that's
or
weird.
Not even, yeah. It's just my first time seeing it. I don't even have one yet.
So literally less than a week before it's released, and yeah. you haven't seen it yet.
Yeah. It's a very efficient business we run here, right? It's very efficient.
I would think that they would pass this by you for approval a thousand yeah. times
have
over.
They at least let yeah. you listen to it yet?
Yeah.
Okay, good.
It's all digital these days. You know, you figure it all out on, you know, with emails and all that, but it's, you know, you don't really get a hard copy until.
That's one of the most fascinating parts of the Nirvana exhibit, by the way, which just opened last weekend. So if you have some free time today,
yeah,
I know you're heading
yeah.
down to Portland, you should check that out. That
yeah.
Bringing Punk to the Masses, which just opened on Friday. But one of the coolest items that they have on display is the photo of the cover of Nevermind, so the little baby
footy, right.
with all the comments from the photographer and the you know the label and whatever,
yeah.
shooting messages back and forth. And one of the big discussions is whether or not the baby's penis should stay
oh, yeah.
or go.
Yeah,
and,
I'm sure it
so
is.
So there's like a little note on the
yeah.
On the margin saying, you know, we could lose the baby's penis if necessary. And at that
baby's
time,
like,
it was
no!
yeah, at that time it was probably literally. We'll just that baby will lose his penis if you say so, Kirk. The baby will lose a penis. So check that out if you get a chance. And thanks again for stopping by,
no,
Dan.
Anytime, man. I loved it.
Dan Laius from Augustana. People, pronounce it right, all right? Don't be ignorant.
Augustana, everybody.
And Brian, thank you for being here.
My pleasure.
And for letting me know what sports are all about. Brian Muchinski, let's get him fired from his legal job so he can be here on a regular
I think it'll
day.
Take about two more appearances. And
two more,
there.
And then you're yeah. done. Tomorrow, a brilliant violin player by the name of Jeffrey Castle will be here, plus editor-in-chief from the Seattle Weekly will be our co-host, Mike Seeley, makes his bi-weekly visit. Hopefully we'll see you on the boat tonight. It leaves from Pier 55 at 7 p.m., so get there by 6:30 so that we can all board, and it's all ages. You know my fight for the all-ages show. I want everyone to be able to experience music. It shouldn't always be blocked out because mommy and daddy are getting drunk.
Bring your grandma. All ages.
All right. Thanks very much for being here today. We'll see you again tomorrow morning at 9:30.
Wholly independent since 2009, this has been the Marty Reimer Show podcast. For more information about topics discussed, visit our website, MartyReimer.com. That's Marty, R-I-E-M-E-R.com. Thank you for subscribing to the podcast. Tell your friends. They look nice. Oh, and to subscribe to our podcast, that too. The Marty Reimer Show is a production of Twisted Scholar Incorporated. Remember, in America, a corporation is a person too. I'm your hungover announcer, Blair Schultz. See you next time. Word out.
Bye-bye, Daddy. Bye-bye, Yaz. Yes.